So,
her name is Maria, dang.
Yeah, man, that was actually unintentional, but okay. Okay, so, could everyone roll a, survival check?
Oh, man, that's like my best skill.
Okay, all right.
Mediocre.
Balls.
Okay.
Go away, please.
Wow, yeah, wait.
You rolled good, and then... What? Ogre. And you can, track them to their lair from here by following the tracks, because you are good at tracking. Let me just paste you guys in here. Okay, so here you are, outside the goblin lair. So you've been traveling for about an hour, and you arrive near the mouth of a cave, and sort of you're from a distance. And you can see in the distance, and you sort of just are quiet and sneaky. I just need a token for this. Okay, so there is a human in a hood and cloak, and a goblin. There we go. And Ben is talking to the goblin, and so you sort of sneak so that you're not seen. And the goblin says in...
Oh, sorry,
have I not moved you onto the new... I haven't moved you to the goblin lair. Okay, hang on, I forgot to obscure it. Give me a moment. I forgot to turn on Fog of War enabled, and close that, and reveal area. Let's reveal this, and reveal that, and reveal just inside the cave like that, and now move you over to there. Okay.
Yay.
Right, sorry. So you arrive, you're up in the top left corner, and you're probably more distant than you appear on this map, but you're just close enough to you kind of in some like brush and low vegetation that is easy to hide in, so they can't see you or hear you. And you can hear a goblin talking in like he's speaking common but kind of poorly to a human. And the goblin's like, only one raiding group return. They bring prisoners. Other raiding groups return soon. No more snake coin people found. And there's a human in a hood. So it sounds and looks like they're probably a human under the hood and a male. And the guy says, excellent. Tell Gorunk that my friends and I will pay lots of coin and give lots of gifts for all dragon artifacts you can find, and kill any humans you find near your home. The goblin nods and enters the cave, and the cloaked figure whispers a word and vanishes. Just goes poof.
Snap.
Okay, so goblin's gone into the cave.
Well, none of us are humans, so we're all safe.
Yeah.
That
works. That works out well.
Just roll right in.
Yeah, we're two elves, half and a robot.
Or
two elves and two robots.
A
amazing. Those 12's a robot and a cat, woman. Furry.
Alright. So, it looks pretty dark in there, so the three of you should be able to see reasonably well, but Await won't be able to see in there because it is dark.
Oh, great.
It's unlit. The ceiling is about 10 feet high, and it is a dark, unlit cave, of the sort you can imagine a young dragon may be living in, but it seems like this place is inhabited by goblins, so probably no dragons in there.
We do, like, an investigation to make sure there's no kind of traps or anything?
That would be a perception check.
Perception, got it.
Well, that's a good idea.
Okay.
Ha! Perception.
Okay, let's see what you rolled. Oh, very good. Okay, some good. You do not see any traps in your immediate vicinity. Let me just reveal like that. It's dark in here, and you can, however, with your perception check, you can hear soft guttural mumbling coming from behind the eastern wall where the passageway turns to the south. So, in fact, you notice that there are, in this wall here, there are some small holes in the wall. Allowing for viewing up the passage by creatures behind the wall. Piles of rubber are large enough to allow creatures to hide as they move up the passage. Okay, so you can see there are two goblins in there. Let me just grab a goblin or two. So you can see. So you can see it here like this, and you can see there are two goblins. And they're just kind of, just chattering away in Goblin, and they're not really paying any attention, chilling.
Can I listen in on them?
You speak Goblin, don't you?
Because I know Goblin, yes. I'm so excited.
They're talking about how the humans are willing to pay for dragon artifacts, and they're quite excited about that, but also they're not sure because they haven't found a dragon artifact in this cave in ages. It's been cleared out, and it's not like they'll get to see any of it anyway because the boss would totally just take it off them. So
oh, too bad for them. Okay,
why is this thing laid out like this? This sucks. Okay, so that's A, B, and C. A is the entrance passage. Okay. Alright, so then you have, there is a room to the south of you. Just wait a minute before you, just in case there's something, because this adventure is laid out horribly and I have to keep zooming back and forth. Okay, you also, with your powers of perception, noticed something in here, which is that there is a tripwire.
Ooh.
Here.
Oh my.
Okay. There's a tripwire there. It's roughly 2 feet above the ground. You've noticed it. Should be able to disarm it if you can give him the give him some light to be able to see it. The problem is, if you make some light, it may well shine through those holes, and the goblins might be alerted to your presence.
Why don't we just jump over it?
Easy.
Oh, 8 can't see it.
Throw 08 over it!
Yeah, I was gonna say, let's pick him up and pass him over.
Oh, yeah. You can easily pick him up and chuck him over.
Yeah, alright, do that. Sure, I'm okay
that
with
that. That seems easier to me!
Assholes.
Alright, elf power, let's do this.
Alright,
okay.
Great.
And all right. Do we have to do a strength check?
No, you can easily pick him up. Good. He's well within your weight limit.
Great.
Especially Ven. Ven should easily be able to do it.
I am quite strong, yes.
Do it, Ven!
Right.
Especially all right,
I have
over here.
Problems with you, but...
all right.
Let's not get caught, so you're just gonna have to trust me on this one, though. Come over here.
Alright, whatever. Okay, whatever fucking shit.
Okay.
Alright, do the thing.
Okay, let's toss him over.
Alright, okay, so you elves...
Because you threw me?
It was a gentle toss!
I'm not just, like, chucking you at the wall.
Okay, so...
He, like, ricochets off the wall and smacks you in the face.
It's like a fucking flying
Alright, so... Await's been chucked into this room.
Great.
He cannot see a thing. It is dark in here.
Fantastic.
Can we step over the...
Yep,
you guys can see in the dark, so you nimbly step over with your elven gracefulness. Okay, so, so over here there is a curtain of wolf pelts.
Ooh.
I'm sure this place is probably really fascinating.
I wonder what...
Take my word for it, it's great!
Okay.
I wonder what Marlo thinks about this.
Well, she's not a vegan.
But it's wolf pelt. Hmm, what is Friend of Furry's opinion on wolves?
Well, she might steal one later.
She can turn into a wolf.
I thought about doing that, actually. But then I decided against it.
Yeah, that's not very calming, actually.
Alright.
Shall we look inside the wolf pelt curtain?
Yeah, yes!
Let's peer into this magic barrier.
You carefully peer through, the wolf pelt curtain. You can see 5 to 15. Oh yeah, you can see for miles, elves. Okay,
Dad boys.
You can
see... Charles Barkley!
It's actually a wolf.
It's Charles Barkley!
They're wolves, but I didn't have a wolf, so...
Oh!
Alright.
Save the dog! Save the dog!
Yeah, how do I get in there?
Save the baby!
Okay, you can get in there by just pushing the pelts aside, but you already are aware that there are goblins in that room.
Well, that's
assuming
why
that the holes...
It's dire, Charles Barkley.
Can I steal one of the wolf pelts just to have?
Wasn't Charles Barkley already a
Wear it.
If you might have trouble stealing it discreetly,
I'll steal it later then. I'll have a fursuit.
What would a dire Charles Barkley, the basketball player, look like?
Oh no.
That's a threat. Wait, hold on.
Isn't he already dire?
Hold on.
Maybe. Are you Googling dire Charles Barkley? Oh wait a minute! I know what you're looking at.
We need to get Michael Jordan up here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. If it's what I think it is.
I hope it. Oh, that's awesome.
It actually was pretty good.
Oh my god.
That's Dire Charles Barkley.
Yeah, you're
Dire
right.
Charles Barkley.
I was thinking of Dino Barkley from the end of Charles Barkley Shut Up and Jam.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I was thinking of...
No, Charles Barkley versus Godzilla.
I was just thinking of Michael Jordan from Shut Up and Jam Gaiden.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Alright.
Through the curtain? It doesn't look like there's anywhere else to go.
I just realized those are two cranking
Let's
boards.
Be careful.
No, they don't have his hat.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Have his hat.
It's true.
Or his Twitter handle.
Yeah.
It's too bad I never updated that Twitter. I need to put some things on that.
Okay. So are you just gonna barge on through? Okay, are you rolling a stealth check?
I will now.
Okay, that's an excellent stealth check for Ben. Very good. Amazing.
Wow.
I wanted to
be
sneaky.
Await can't see a thing, by the way. This is still a thing.
Await, I'll hold your hand.
An excellent stealth check,
at least. I'm gonna hold your hand, Await. Come
with me. I've got this. I'm the stealthiest robot.
Clank, 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 clank.
Yeah.
Stealthy bucket of bolts. Okay. I can't believe this.
C-3PO, unlike C-3PO, can move without being
quiet. Oh, wait, stop. Let me just... Wait. Jeez, let me get... Okay.
So
now you can see this room.
You've
just sneaked round the corner. There are three goblins in here, and a cage full of wolves. This goblin over here is right next to the wolf pens. And could let them out to, like, attack you if he sees you.
Okay.
Oh, I've got a shiny new trick for this.
But they won't attack us, though, because...
Magic missile.
Wild. Magic missile, ooh.
I could just do it.
Well?
Do what?
Magic missile.
Oh,
oh wait, sorry, I put in one too many wolves. There's supposed to be two wolves.
Can I use a spell as an action just outside of combat?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna use Speak with Animals just in case, right now.
Okay. Oh wait, does it have a V component?
Let's see.
When you cast it. Should say things like S, V,
yes.
And
oh.
Okay, that would mean that you have to speak to cast it.
Oh, I can't whisper.
Sorry, no. If it's got a V component, it means you have to speak. Does it have a V?
It does.
Right, you have to say to cast it then. So
okay,
you can't
I'll
do
hold
that
off on that for now. Okay. Maybe later.
Relay that order, number one. But any spell that doesn't have a V component, you can cast silently.
What does the S stand for?
Somatic. It's movements, like it involves like gestures and things.
Magic missile.
And the other one is M, which is material component.
Now I know.
Yeah.
Knowing is half the battle.
2-2 on yourself.
See, now if Await could see right now, he'd be able to use like a sneak attack against this guy, but he can't see, so
that'd be great, wouldn't it?
We should probably just
stagger around the darkness.
We should probably just stealth past these guys. We rolled amazing stealth checks.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
We've all rolled above 20. But I wanna where'd one of the wolves go?
Sorry, I put in one too many wolves.
Okay.
Supposed to be two.
I was just wondering where it went.
Sorry.
Oh man,
that was my mistake.
When there's like one fewer velociraptors than there should be, and then you look and there's one behind you.
Clever girl.
I just thought of a really bad joke. When you said something about the V component, your mom has the V component.
Oh shoot!
Oh,
are you fucking serious?
Burn?
Wow.
Burn? I don't even know if that is burn.
Get
fucked. Something.
Nerd.
Like it's kind of a given that she does.
Yeah.
She gave birth to you, so
yeah.
I mean, unless you're
if
adopted,
she is your mother.
Then who knows?
Yeah. And it has a description. It says, like the previous room, this one contains mostly bedrolls and a few decrepit furniture. Where the goblins rest and relax when not out doing the terrible things goblins do. Three cages against the wall between two doors, two of which house a single wolf each. they snarl and snap in your direction, except they don't because nobody's seen you. although, I guess elves can probably smell you, maybe? Maybe, I don't know, unless elves have no BO, which I could completely believe.
They just smell wonderful.
They just smell like nature and freshly washed.
Here's the description for 08.
Oh my god.
Here's the description for 08. The room is dark. You're likely to be eaten by a Gru.
Good. Yeah.
Man, I really wanna team up with those wolves, but I can't think of how to make that happen.
Well, I could turn into a wolf.
I could, but then I wouldn't be. Wouldn't be like stealthy, and the you goblins would stealthy. See me and be like, "Why be is there a wolf?" Well,
you could be stealthy as a wolf. Wolves have good dexterity, don't they?
I don't know. All right, fine. I'm gonna turn into a wolf.
Yeah, but whenever you shapeshift, you have to make a really cool sound effect, like
Dwayne. Find out. You can even turn into a dire wolf.
I want to turn into Balto. What?
Oh my god.
Oh, what's funny?
That was a deep cut. Nobody knows about Balto.
What's funny?
Nobody knows about Balto.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I know.
Do you know how many furries that movie created?
Yeah, actually. Like, if fucking you turn all into of them. Wolves are actually kind of awesome for stealth. Let me check.
Kevin Bacon's
greatest role. Wolf or a dire wolf has they have 15 dex and they get a +4 to stealth checks.
Yeah,
they also have advantage on perception checks that use their sense of smell or hearing, and they get advantage on attack rolls against creatures. Oh wait, I don't think you'd get that though, because so you'd actually still be pretty stealthy as a wolf or a dire wolf.
Guys, check this out. Are they dire wolves?
No, they're normal wolves. But
okay,
dire
then
wolf
I
want to
be
just
a
like
wolf.
Giant wolf.
I want to be a normal wolf, so they'll trust me.
So
I can gain their trust.
Oh wait, attempts to intimidate.
Okay,
group.
So you. Okay, wolf.
Did I intimidate the group?
Hang on, you went to Charles Barkley, so I can tell you about. Perfect.
That's adorable.
Right. Okay. So I'll just.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Okay. So
the other wolves are making like growly faces, but
and you're making them like
this. Just happy. Like, oh, hi guys.
Oh hey.
See, they're Mighty Unna in Pokemon battles, and you're Mighty Unna in Pokemon Anime.
Yeah.
Blep.
Pokemon Anime.
That was probably the stupidest joke I could have made right there.
I lost half of my number, by the way. I feel like I need to say this because French.
Go of your hand and suddenly just turns into a wolf.
Before I say check this out, and then I turn into a wolf. Just
boy,
for
that
maximum
looked amazing.
Cool.
I was really impressed.
Do a flip.
Yeah. Oh right, you can't. Oh fuck. Well, just take my word for it that it was cool.
Roll a charisma check.
Right. Hang on.
Except you can't say any of that stuff because you can't talk
whispering.
Now.
Well, I whispered it before I turned into a wolf.
Okay.
Okay, everybody whisper from now on. I'm gonna move over here. Sneakily. Do I have to roll a stealth
check? Yeah, roll a stealth check.
Okay. Just in case I trip over massive wolf feet and fall on my fucking face.
Okay, that's a really right, good stealth check.
Yeah. Get over here.
Okay. The wolves. A perception check.
You are saved from charisma. Oh. Good job.
perception is okay. They
to avoid charisma.
Good job.
The wolves. Okay. Oh, sorry, you can't move that thing.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'll just make it so that people can edit and move this. So, hang on, I'll just make it so that one is you as well, just to confuse things. Okay, so you should be able to control it now.
Okay, cool. Alright, so Marlon sidles up to the wolf cage and whispers, "What are you guys in for?" to gain their trust.
The wolves sort of come on over and you get that they're serving the goblins who feed them and stuff, but they'd rather be out in the wilds because there are like there are no girls in here. It's so boring.
Yeah, I feel that. Like, I can definitely relate.
And like they kind of like, "Oh, how are you doing? You're a good looking lady wolf. Wow."
Hey, I mean,
such lady wolf. Wow.
Sorry,
yeah, but, I guess so.
Sorry, but these dogs are barking up the wrong tree.
Well, anyway, oh yeah, well, you know, I was just thinking that if you help, I help you guys get out of this cage, then you could help us, with our goblin problem. Shh! I'm being alluring. I'm charming them.
All right, whatever.
Oh yeah, doll face, say the wolves, anything for you.
Okay.
Because that's what wolves are like, obviously.
He is a real girl. Yeah, does a pretty fake much. Girl voice. All right, checks out.
Can I just say one? That was the plan.
A woo, baby.
And you got one.
Got one.
Congratulations.
Well, anyway,
okay.
Where's the cage door located?
The door is over here.
Oh, shit. How am I going to get it open?
You can see that this goblin here it's not anything difficult. It's just a latch. It's just a basic latch that the goblin could push up.
Could I nose it open as a wolf? As a wolf?
Probably. Wolf is dexterous enough to do that.
Yeah. Okay, do I have to stealth again? Because this is...
No, you're stealthed.
I'm pushing it here. I'm stealthing right up.
You're stealthed, and you rolled a really good stealth check, so that goblin has no idea you're there. Right.
Stealthy, super stealthy dog, wolf. Move up. And just open. And...
Okay, it makes a loud creaking noise, like, but like by the time the goblin whips around, as soon as he does, suddenly he's set upon by wolves.
Oh,
like,
oh shit!
and then like these other goblins over here are like, "Oh shit!"
Bow wow 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 wow
wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow
wow wow wow wow
wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow
wow wow wow
wow wow wow wow wow wow wow wow
wow wow wow wow wow wow wow
wow But we might have to resolve this combat next time because we are at the end of the session.
Oh, oh snap. Boy.
Oh snap.
Just get rid of that goblin.
Yeah, fuck him, he got eaten.
Yeah, he got owned. Alright, so join us next time when we find out the thrilling conclusion to this part of the adventure and find out what happened.
Yes.
So thank you everyone for watching the Friday Night Dungeon Crawl, and thanks for our players, and join us next week.
And I'll see you guys on
Bye everyone.
Hearthstones.
Oh my gosh! Who drew catpaulism?
Oh, it was somebody in the chat. Whoever was in the chat, say...
Holy shit, that's amazing.
Person in the chat, come forward. Oh,
yeah,
Cortana,
come forward.
Cortana was interested in what I had to say. Hey, Cortana.
What?
Hey, Cortana.
What?
Fuck off.
Okay.
It's a strange rabbit, I think, is the one who drew it.
Was it a strange rabbit? The chat deleted after certain points, so... Oh, wait, no, wait, it was...
They got a...
Yeah, it was a stranger rabbit.
Yep.
Hey!
Yeah.
Good job.
Nice.
Hey.
Nice.
Good job on the art.
Nice. Nice. All right. I'm going to stop the stream now.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye.
All right.
Bye. Thanks for watching.
Until next time.